Witches, number 24. Starting at small forward, 6 feet, 7 inches. Number 3, OG Ananobi. At the other forward position, at 6 foot, 9 inches, number 43. Shooting guard, 6 feet, 1 inches, number 23, Fred VanVleet. Your Hometown head coach, Steve Nurse. Ladies and gentlemen, your Toronto Raptors.
It's been an absolute war out there, neither side giving in. Both want to advance to the next round. It's the Eastern Conference Playoff Game 6, right here on 2K Sports. Moments away, it'll be the Philadelphia 76ers going up against the Toronto Raptors at Scotiabank Arena. With Hall of Famer Doris Burke and Greg Anthony, this is Kevin Harlan. On the sidelines, we have David Aldridge reporting. Hey, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. 2019's most improved player, Pascal Siakam, went from an energy player to an all-star. Siakam said, "After every season, I look at the things I have to do better. When the summertime comes, I just attack it and work. It's about making sure that I'm a better player than I was the year before." Kevin?
Oh, you know what? I love that work ethic. Thanks, D.A.
Look at the 76ers starting group. Harris and Embiid together in the middle. Shake Milton is out there with George Hill, and it's Green in at the three slot. And for the Raptors, Ananobi and Siakam in at the forward slots. Lowry out there with Fred VanVleet, and it's Birch in at the five, roaming the paint. So Philadelphia will get the first possession. Hill passes to Harris. It's back to Hill. Embiid, and the layup's good off the glass.
You see that nasty streak Embiid possesses. Part of why he's a superstar. Great motor.
Ananobi, good.
And it's always nice to get the easy look inside for your first points of the game.
Pass to Embiid. Good off, you're moving the ball around. Out to Harris for three. And chance shot, and Embiid lays it in. Embiid's got his second basket of the game.
Offensively, we see Embiid all over the floor, but inside is where he can really utilize that size.
Here's Birch. And the foul called on Danny Green. That is his first foul of the game.
Ref's calling it close already as he picks up a quick early foul.
Lowry kicks to Ananobi. Knocks it loose. And it's out of bounds. The Raptors able to retain possession here. Six to shoot. Lowry inside the line. And that one is off. Now the 76ers take it the other way. And it's Hill penetrating. Birch grabs the board. Against Green. VanVleet looking around. Lowry against Harris. Here's the teardrop.
One of the premier shot swatters in the world. The length of Embiid makes it hard to be scored on.
That's in, and he's now 3 for 3 and looking sharp.
And the D getting out work there on the putback. Can't let that happen.
You have got to put a body on somebody. We talk about it ad nauseum, but you've got to be disciplined with the box outs.
Now, here's Siakam. Some solid defense from Harris. And a little over 2.5 minutes gone here in the first on the wing hill. Good work defensively by Lowry. Raptors trail by 4. In the corner, it's Van Vliet. Now, here is Lowry. And the officials call him for a 3-second violation. How about that strong defensive performance for this half's mobile one block?
And it's a different kind of defense teams play in the postseason. More in your face, physical, high energy plays like that one.
The 76ers leading by 4. Hilton the pass to Harris. It's hauled in by the Raptors.
That's not the type of opportunity he fails to convert very often.
Anunoby, good.
And can't do much else. The strength of Anunoby comes in handy on those challenging things.
Pass to Harris, outside Hill. The dish to Embiid. That shot misses. Toronto, they've gone 2-5 here, making 40% so far to start out the game. Siakam misses.
And it didn't fall, but that's the kind of shot they want their offense to create.
You know, it can be frustrating when you make the right play and fail to reap the rewards. You just have to stay with it here.
And that one clearly a foul. Gets the whistle and 2 shots coming up.
Just for this trip to the line, I'll call him by his full name. Frederick Edmund Van Vliet Sr. Had to get that in there. Now we can just go back to Freddie V.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First one falls for. Ben Simmons, he's checked in for Danny Green. Drops. He ties it up.
This is about the last guy you want to center the stripe right now. They keep fouling him and he keeps making them.
And Philadelphia decides to take their first timeout right here.
And with their offense sputtering, coaches got to get them back on track.
And to me, they're just taking too many tough shots. And when they do get an easy one, the confidence just isn't there.
The 76ers shooting a mere 25% from the floor in this first quarter. Shoots from the right block. Here's Embiid. Laid in with a nice touch off the glass. Embiid's got 8.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Lowry and the rejection by Embiid. To the paint. Here's Simmons. And Simmons slams it in.
Appreciated the unselfish nature of George Hill. He always has his eyes surveying the floor.
Pass to Siakam. Good, and Van Vliet gets the assist.
And they've scored several times already here in the first quarter on the inside.
Hill dishes to Harris. And Embiid gets it to go. He's got 10.
Well, I absolutely love the way this guy has controlled the pace tonight. They've been able to play the style they want.
Lowry's shot shot is good.
Well, you love the unselfishness of Fred VanVleet. This guy is so good recognizing when his teammates are open.
Here's Embiid. Harris trying to get free. Embiid, no good. And the bucket is good. Three-point play chance here for him.
It's going to be Embiid shooting.
Kyle Lowry picks one up there. The 76ers shooting their first free throw of the night here. Both teams will make substitutions. The free throw drops for Embiid.
Really an underrated part of Embiid's game. Excellent as a foul shooter for a seven-footer, so you just can't hack away at it.
Now here is Lowry, and he's going up for the alley-oop. Throws down the alley-oop slam.
Chemistry at its best. An unreal alley-oop.
Yeah, you're right. The pass, the catch, the dunk. All of it perfect. Baines against Embiid. Maxey, and here's Harris from the arc. Not his night so far. That's miss number five with no makes.
A team's rebounding is a great measure of its energy, and theirs has been terrific here in the first quarter.
Lowry, good.
I thought he might get a call there. I thought it was pretty clear contact, but we know Lowry's not looking for the whistle. This guy's just looking to put points on the board.
Now here is Harris. He's gotten some minutes, but nothing on the board yet.
And with the offense getting right to the rim, at least they saved the layup.
It's his first trip to the line. First one at the line is good. Johnson, he's checked in for Kyle Lowry. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Howard's checked in for Joel Embiid. And Harris drops them both. Raptors trail by three. Here's Trent. The pass to Hood. And here's Boucher. And that one, good. Boucher's got his second basket of the night.
Moving it around, eight of their last 10 coming off assists.
Here's Harris. That's his first basket of the game. 1 for 6 and looking for more.
And how about that exhale there? Finally gets one to fall through 6 attempts.
Here's Trent, and it's sent back by Howard.
There's a reason Dwight Howard has so many all-defensive teams to his credit. Good night with the block.
Oh, good with the triple. So it's Johnson who brings the ball up for the Raptors. It's a three-point game. Popped up there for Howard, and it's Howard finishing it off.
That's about communication between teammates. Dwight Howard high-flying as ever.
Pass to Hood. And the foul called on Korkmaz. That's his first foul. Outside Hood. Shot clock at 6. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
At 6'8", Rodney Hood is so effective at getting fouled on his way up. This guy's so smart.
For Toronto, they have had 2 chances at the line already, making them both.
Take a break. 2 shots.
The first one falls.
And the former Blue Devil continues to enhance his offensive repertoire. Rodney Hood, a reliable two-way guard.
And that's good as he hits both of his shots. Philadelphia leading by three. Now, here's Maxey. No points in the game yet for him. The second effort, Howard can't hit. Toronto, they've gone an even 50% from the field. They are 7-14 for the game. And the Raptors miss again.
Well, certainly not the best defensive effort, but this guy can't make them pay for their laziness.
Maxey, no good. Toronto shooting 47% here so far. Here's Trent. Pass to Baines. Shot clock at five. It's good. He makes his first shot of the game.
Well, exposing a weakness in the defense, that's just way too easy, guys.
And Philadelphia calls time here.
Good timing. They're really struggling offensively.
Sometimes it just feels like misses become contagious. He wants to settle his guys down right now.
Philadelphia moving the ball around. Here's Howard. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Howard's got his second bucket tonight.
Boy, guys, the powerful physical frame of Dwight Howard, so problematic for a defense.
Hood, the pass to Baines. Here's Trent. Six on the shot clock. Pulls up. It's hauled in by Harris. Philadelphia leading by three. Here's Korkmaz. Nice work on the boards, paying off with the basket.
This guy is just working his tail off on the boards. You love the effort, love the energy. Well, just a little too physical out there right now. That's already his second foul.
The Raptors have hit all four of their chances so far in this one.
Toronto, Chris Boucher, taking two shots.
Shooting two.
And that one falls for Boucher. Good on both. 1:30 left in the first. Harris outside. That one falls. Harris has got 6 points.
And they've repeatedly probed inside in the first half, guys, and it's paid off.
Johnson outside. Back to Hood. Johnson outside. Here's Boucher. It's good with the assist that time from Johnson. He's got eight.
Well, that's not the guy you want guarding him at the rim. Just too much of a differential in terms of size.
Inside and good that time, and the 76ers lead by five.
This guy can do so much for you on the offensive end, and that is why his number gets called time and time again.
Simmons against Hood, kicks it to Johnston. Four on the shot clock. Here's Trent, good on the 3-point shot. 16 seconds left to play in the first quarter. Here's Simmons, and the call on the shot that sends him to the line.
And what patience from Simmons on offense. So skilled at making the D feel nervous when he has to rock.
This is his first trip to the line tonight.
he's off on the first.
The first pick in the 2016 NBA draft, Simmons has been a phenomenal addition to our league.
And the second free throw, good. There's 10 seconds left in the first quarter. Here's Van Vliet. Good work there as it goes.
Well, if you think about Fred Van Vliet's handle and his ability to operate at different speeds, you understand how effective he can be on the drive.
A big-time effort for Joel Embiid, providing a lot of energy for the Philadelphia 76ers. Scoring, rebounding, he was all over the place during that quarter. They are riding his performance right now. Right back after this break. And we spoke with Joel Embiid earlier. He hopes to set an example for those who want to follow in his footsteps.
Being from Africa, at the end of the day, you come here, you want to make an impact and, you know, share your story with everybody. And so it kind of pushes everybody back home in the whole continent to want to do the same thing.
Well said. Certainly, Greg Embiid puts himself front and center, willing to lead the cause on and off the floor.
And this is where his big personality helps. He has a larger-than-life quality that really just captivates people.
And we're back. Good to have you with us for 2K Sports coverage of Game 6. What stands out to you guys from the 76ers in this one?
Just cashing in on second-chance opportunities. That's how they built this early lead.
Yeah, the defense hasn't been there. They are getting hammered on second-chance opportunities.
And now, brought to you by Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go. Let's reset our lineups. Taking a look at the 76ers. They've got Shake Milton. Simmons is out there with Howard. Then it's George Hill. And it's Green in at the three, the small forward. The Raptors making a switch here. Siakam's checked in. And the free throw is good, now leading by one.
Well, what you know is OG Anunoby has certainly seen a lot of the world. This young man, born in London, moved to Missouri as a young man, goes to Indiana University, and then gets drafted by Toronto. That's country to country, folks.
And he's an automatic finisher when he gets into that area.
He is, and he picks the simple one-hand stuff to get the 2 points. Passes it to Boucher. Lock at six. From deep three-point range, and Simmons with the rebound.
And when you are as good a shooter as he is, you have to have the confidence to take that shot. It might not always fall.
And for most guys, I think you only want to take that shot if you've hit a few in a row. That is absolutely a heat check.
And the pass to Van Vliet. And he banks in the layup. Van Vliet's got his second bucket of the night.
So important as a point guard in a pick-and-roll play to understand when it's your turn to score it. Fred Van Vliet does just that.
Now, here's Milton. He's guarded closer. Here's Howard. Banked in off the glass. Howard's got six.
This is a comfort zone for Dwight Howard. The closer he is to the hoop, the more effective he becomes.
Here's Siakam. And contact on the shot, so he'll be shooting free throws here. That's on Ben Simmons. Raptors have been at their finest form at the free throw line tonight. 8 attempts, 8 makes.
2 shots.
Shooting 2.
And he knocks down the first one.
And getting to the line and hitting your free throws, a good way to get back into the game. It stops the clock and extends the game and allows you the opportunity to set your defense. They've been perfect from the line so far here in the second quarter.
Joel Embiid, he's checked in for Ben Simmons. Siakam hits them both.
This is what makes him a challenge to stop. He will beat you from the floor, and he can also beat you from the line.
Milton with it. He's been patient so far. Nothing on the scoreboard yet. Good D by Siakam.
Boy, if you're going up against this guy in this close a range, you've got to defend with everything you've got. A tremendous job defensively.
Now, Milton. Embiid kicks to Milton. Puts it up from 12. Birch grabs the board. Birch has got his fourth rebound with that last one here tonight. VanVleet wide open. And again, Toronto no luck. The 76ers lead. Outside Hill. Birch grabs the board. Birch has got his fifth rebound right now in the game. And they take the lead. VanVleet's got the lead up to one now for the Raptors.
What you see is continued improvement in his ability to create for others. Great to see OG Anunoby make the open read.
VanVleet against Green. VanVleet passes to Anunoby. To the inside. Lowry kicks to VanVleet. A three. A shot by Lowry, no good.
And he didn't punish them for the weak coverage there, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
And Embiid throws it down.
Hard to imagine a much better target on the alley-oop than Embiid. Get the lob anywhere in his vicinity, and you might wind up on a highlight reel.
So, timeout called here, the first for Toronto. They're looking to build on Monday's big win.
Yeah, it was all hands on deck. Helps to get points off the bench when you're on the road.
One thing we know, great teams in the NBA get production off the bench, and that was critical that night.
Against Hill. Siakam looking around.
And boy, have they been hitting the backboard in this game or what? Kind of surprising it's such a tight game.
Hill passes to Green. Milton with it. Just five on the clock. Poked away. The 76ers need to get off a shot. And they force the shot clock violation. Great team. Toronto trailing. And here's Lowry. And he lays it straight in. Lowry's got six.
I tell you, this guy just loves having the ball in his hands. And why not when Lowry can make moves like that?
Pass to Milton. He's just scored his first basket with that shot, making him 1 for 4. Six changes of the lead here.
Yeah, both teams still kind of feeling their way through this game.
Here's VanVleet and the rejection by Embiid. To the middle. And that'll be two free throws coming up. Officials on the call with the foul.
Now George Hill forces the action inside. Terrific control in the paint, and he earns the call thanks to his aggressiveness.
The 76ers shooting their sixth and seventh free throws in the game. Free throw drops for Hill.
Well, George Hill has always had the term pro attached to his name. Why? Well, he can make shots. He's willing to facilitate. He defends at a high level. Truly an incredible teammate.
Aaron Baines, he's checked in for the Raptors. And then for Philadelphia, Tobias Harris has checked in for Howard. And Maxey subbed in for Shake Milton. Raptors trail by three. They've been looking out of sync offensively.
Yeah, their offense has ground to a standstill.
Van Vliet kicks to Lowry. Off the mark there with the three-point shot. And here's Hill, who will bring it up for Philadelphia. Pass to Green. Passes it to Maxey. Six on the shot clock. Unloads. With nobody on him, he buries the jumper. And the 76ers lead by five. The pass to Lowry. Poked loose. It's stolen by Hill. He kicks to Embiid. Misses the three. Toronto's got nothing but zeros from long range in the second quarter. 0-4. The shot by Lowry, no good.
This has not been a good period for this guy. Out of sync, not letting the game come to him. He's got to settle down and make shots.
Hill passes to Embiid. They kick it out to Green. Shot clock at six. Here's Maxey. And out of bounds as the Raptors gain possession. The Raptors making a switch here. Hood's checked in. The 76ers also with a sub. Korkmaz is checked in. Raptors trail by five. Now here's Van Vliet. He's got eight. And Embiid with the block. Here's Korkmaz. Now recovering. Embiid inside the line. Off the mark with the outside fadeaway. Outside Lowry. Their offense, stone cold. Another miss there.
This guy cannot get started, and the offense overall has been a struggle because of it.
Toronto shooting the ball at 42%. Hood with it, picked up by Harris. Pass to Lowry. Down to five on the shot clock. Looking to get back on track here. No good there. And it's Philadelphia the other way. Baines with the block. They push it up. 4-on-3. That's Lowry again missing.
He is just not taking smart shots out there. A pattern he has fallen into tonight.
And it goes down 2 points.
Boy, that's beautiful touch on the floater. And let's remember, not everyone has that shot in their arsenal.
And the Raptors call time here.
Well, it's been an express lane to the rim. Coach can't be happy about that.
Well, poor rotations, poor communication. There's a lot to figure out right now.
Making substitutions here. Here's Hood. Johnson outside. Just five to shoot. And stolen by Simmons. And Harris wide open. He shoots. And oh, the blocked shot grabs it out of the air. To end the run, and they call the foul, so he's got the and one chance here to make it a three-point play.
And part of the reason they're down is that they haven't been as strong in the paint here in the second.
The Raptors haven't made a mistake at the line yet, 10 of 10.
What's up?
by four. Harris outside. 2 points. That one goes.
The length and strength of Harris gives him an advantage on contested jumpers that the other players simply don't have.
Pass to Baines. That shot, no good. Good D by Embiid. Philadelphia's gone 0-2 from deep here in the second. Now, here's Maxey. Boucher defending.
Well, when you've been struggling as he has, you love that your teammates have really stepped up and taken the challenge.
Harris against Johnson. Six to shoot. Boucher. Toronto needs to get off his shot. And the Raptors miss again. The 76ers leading by six. And slam dunk by Harris.
And passes like that demonstrate the winning mindset Simmons has. A guy that wants to get his team involved.
Here's Trent. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. That one on Maxey. He made the only free throw attempt he had earlier in the game.
Taking two shots.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That free throw, no good. Fred VanVleet is checked in for Toronto. Good on the second free throw. Here's Maxey. Here's Philadelphia. They're on a 14-6 run. Embiid dishes to Harris. Back to Embiid. And it's blocked.
Boy, a tough go for him in this quarter. You can see how desperately he wants to get things started. He just can't make a shot.
Whistle blows. Basket is good. So a chance here for a three-point play.
Boy, doesn't get any easier than that. What a size advantage, and just goes to work.
One shot.
And that one falls for Boucher. 56 seconds left to play here in the half. Simmons finds Harris. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Simmons got his fourth assist with that last one here tonight. And VanVleet with the bounce pass. From outside the arc. Rebound by the 76ers. Embiid's got rebound number 12 now. Tenacity on the glass. And Embiid throws it down.
And that interior presence of Embiid, guys that big shouldn't be able to move like that.
VanVleet against Embiid. VanVleet with it. Over Simmons. And that shot was up in time, but doesn't go in. And so it's the Philadelphia 76ers in the driver's seat, up 8 points at the end of the quarter. They're playing a bruising game inside, and it's working for them. And now let's catch up with David Aldridge, who's standing by from the sideline. All right, Dave.
Kevin, thanks. Joel, as you look at the game so far, how would you evaluate yourself?
I think defensively I'm doing pretty good. Offensively, I still got to work on a lot of stuff. But it's going well. I just got to calm down, slow down, let the game come to me, and we'll be all good.
Hey, thanks for your time, man. See you in the second half. Back to you, Kevin.
Thanks for the great interview, David. And we'll be back for the third quarter of basketball following halftime.
And now, the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everybody. Halfway through this round one matchup of the NBA playoffs, Ernie Johnson, Kenny Smith, and Shaq. Taking a look at the 76ers, they clearly can sense how close they are to wrapping up the series in six games. They'd love to close it out here and avoid a game seven. Let's start with you, Shaq. What'd you think about the 76ers?
The presence of Joel Embiid overpowering. Plays physical, puts him back down from anywhere. He really brings an edge to this team.
Looking at Toronto, Kenny, your thoughts?
Well, obviously, they didn't show up on the glass at all. They were getting outworked, out-hustled, and outplayed. Their competition showed just the opposite. They wanted it more. You can't give up a ton of extra possessions in a game like this and expect to win.
And that's going to do it for our halftime show, sadly. Third quarter about to start. See you again after the final
horn. Oh, buzzer.
And we're with you again as our round one coverage continues. Joel Embiid has been sensational.
Well, it didn't take him long to get that double-double. Already has it halfway through the game.
That takes a level of aggression and a level of focus, and he has brought it all night thus far.
And we're happy to have you back for more playoff basketball here in round one. Ananobi and Siakam in at the forward slots. Lowry out there with Fred VanVleet, and it's Birch in at the five. So that's the five in the game for Toronto.
Rise and fire in the catch and shoot. Fred VanVleet ready and willing.
Green inside the three-point line, but they'll get another chance.
And they get it back again. I mean, how many rebounds offensively have they had? Everything's going right for them today.
Stolen by Green. Now here's Milton. Defense right on him. And slam dunk by Harris.
That's a double whammy, guys.
That's right. A great defensive play, then the emphatic dunk.
Let's see if that serves as a momentum builder. What a great sequence for this group.
Shot clock at six. Siakam finds Lowry. Well-timed pass, and he goes straight to the bucket for the layup.
Boy, Pascal Siakam plays at his own pace, able to find the open man.
This is it to Harris. Good ball movement here by the 76ers. Embiid. And we're going to have a jump ball. It's tied up there. His shot was hindered by that momentous mobile one block.
And you've got to take your defense up a notch in the playoffs. He takes it up about three notches on that block.
So it's Toronto now. Raptors trail by eight. Lowry passes to VanVleet. Ananobi in the corner. It's stolen by Harris. And now Philadelphia on the break. They kick it out to Green. Outside Hill. Four on the clock. The feed to Harris. Over Siakam. And there's the shot clock violation. Couldn't get the shot off in time. Howard's checked in for Philadelphia. The Raptors shooting the ball at 42%. Howard against Siakam. And the Raptors miss again.
And they have built their advantage on the scoreboard here by doing all the little things.
And it's slammed in by Howard.
Oh, phenomenal alley-oop slam there.
They are taking advantage of a team that looks lost out there. Toronto calls timeout.
He does not look happy. Their defensive rebounding has been putrid, and they're giving up a ton of second chance points.
just over 2.5 minutes gone by here in the second half. Here's Van Vliet. And again, Toronto no luck. The 76ers leading by 10. From 12 feet out, it's rebounded by Anunoby.
Listen, simply put, he's got to finish that. It's not like the defender was right on top of him.
And a big lead for them on both the scoreboard and the backboard thus far.
Second shot opportunity, and it's Green missing. Toronto, they've gone 2 of 5 shooting here in the third quarter. And there's the pass to Lowry. Van Vliet outside. And he gets the whistle for the 3-second call. And so Green will bring it up for Philadelphia. Just 4 points. That's all they've given up here in the second half. Back to Milton. Good. The assist goes to Hill. Hill's got 3 assists now in this one.
Well, terrific use of the pick and roll. George Hill outstanding at manipulating the passes.
And the ball's tied up, so we'll have a jump ball. And so here's Toronto. 6 on the shot clock. Again with the block.
A defensive stalwart so far. That's 6 blocks.
Greg protecting the rim. Love the hustle. Howard, that's good. Howard's got the lead up to 14 now for the 76ers.
Yeah, they're going to have a nice little run here.
Van Vliet passes to Siakam. Lowry's shot is good.
Now get to that sweet spot. Nice mid-range jumper by Kyle Lowry. So effective.
Now Milton, the 3 from Hill, trains the 3-pointer. Hill's got 7.
Well, he showed right there, this guy capable of making shots, especially if you leave him that wide open.
Lowry drives in, lays it up, and banks it in.
And he's having quite the quarter, converting at a really high percentage.
Timeout called, the 76ers.
Every timeout, a chance to review the lineups, matchups, or call a play.
And the guys get a little bit of a break, mentally, physically, just recharge here quickly.
Philadelphia leading by 13. Hill kicks to Milton. And foul on the shot, so he'll get a chance at the line.
I mean, even from over here, you can see that one pretty clearly.
The 76ers have made 6 of their 7 attempts at the line in this one.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First free throw is good.
And no matter what, one of the big positives they can take away from this game is how well they perform at the line.
And the 76ers with some changes. Ben Simmons, he's checked in for Joel Embiid. And it's Korkmaz in for Green. So he gets them both. Raptors trail by 15. Pass to Boucher. Here's Lowry. They shoot again. Siakam trying to free himself up. And it's sent back by Howard. Here's Korkmaz. He's guarded by Anunoby. Korkmaz passes to Simmons. Pass to Milton. Five to shoot. 14 feet away. It's hauled in by the Raptors. This one for three. It's good from long range. Trench got 10 points in the game.
Well, OG Anunoby is going to continue to develop his game, and that pass, that was pretty.
Here's Milton, and he converts the layup. And the 76ers lead by 14.
When you allow good scorers to get uncontested shots at the rim, no wonder you're losing.
To me, this is simply stated, been a complete lack of defensive attention and focus all night long.
I mean, if the defender is going to play off like that, then you know what's going to happen. There are going to be points put on the board.
Simmons. Here's Howard. Another shot, and he's fouled pretty hard on that shot, but he's got the chance to pick up the points at the line. It's going to be on Siakam.
Well, Dwight Howard makes his way to the free throw line. You've got to stay down on that shot fake. The defender doesn't, and he makes good use of it.
And he makes the first.
Listen, we know Dwight Howard is on the back nine of his career, but he can still be valuable. This guy is capable of a double-double every night.
Johnson, he's checked in for Anunoby. And Philadelphia also making a switch. Maxey's checked in. And both free throws good for Howard.
And if they continue, Kevin, their outstanding free throw shooting, that'll help them seal the deal.
Passes to Siakam. Here's Trent. Kicks it out to Siakam. Here's Johnson. Good D by Howard. And so Simmons will bring it up for Philadelphia.
And sometimes you have no chance at stopping Simmons from the interior. Just a very skilled player who gets these calls routinely.
This is his second trip to the free throw line.
Shooting two.
And the first one drops. That one falls, so he hits both of them. And the Raptors with the ball. They trail by 16. Siakam against Howard. Siakam misses.
I'll tell you, it feels all night like this guy's been forcing shots, rushing shots. He's really struggling on the offensive end.
Here's Simmons. Lays it up off the glass. 9 points for Ben Simmons.
And when Simmons is inside, forget about it. He uses his skill and smarts to take advantage.
Siakam passes to Trent. Makes it off the glass.
What an effective, efficient offensive possession. They'd love to get that shot every trip down the floor.
And here's Maxey. Over Siakam. And a kind roll that time off the rim as that one falls. Maxey's got 6 points. Raptors trail by 18. And there's a whistle, and that's going to go on Simmons. That'll be his second foul of the game. Fred VanVleet is checked in for Johnson. Harris is checked in for the 76ers. And Lowry has it in the corner. Down low, five on the clock. Here's VanVleet. It's deflected. Now, here's Maxey. He's got six. Hopped up there for Howard. Hammers the alley-oop through.
Well, Dwight Howard looking to score, and the coaching staff wants him to get these kinds of shots.
VanVleet outside. Now the pass to Trent. He feeds it to Lowry. And he makes that one.
Well, they're not behind because of this guy. He is putting on a tremendous run.
Here's Simmons. 9 points in the game so far. Good. 18 points for him.
I love how Simmons sets the floor. So good at spotting his teammates for high percentage shots.
Boucher finds Van Vliet.
That's a complete effort. Stuck with his man, gets his hand up, and then he doesn't hesitate to finish the possession with the rebounding job.
Pass to Simmons. Harris trying to get free. Shot's good by Simmons. Simmons got 11 points.
And this is how Simmons puts up points. He challenges you close at the rim more often than not, having the physical advantage.
Van Vliet outside. Pass to Trent. There's the triple. But they get it there. Inside, outside for Lowry. Pass to Boucher. No good from outside. Philadelphia leading by 22. For three, Harris. The basket good off the assist from Simmons. Three. Simmons got his sixth assist on the night. And here's Lowry. He'll bring it up for the Toronto Raptors. 50 seconds left in the third quarter. Here's Siakam. And, yep, finally drops after rolling around the rim.
Well, you love to see Siakam get going. This guy is so good at getting to his spots and converting.
And here we go. Fast break. Van Vliet's got it. Lowry can't get it to go. Philadelphia's gone 2 of 2 from long range in the third quarter so far. And that one's good. Maxey's got 4 points now in the quarter.
I'm sorry. That's poor defense down low again. It's been a mismatch thus far in the paint.
Siakam with it. 6 points for him. Releases. Not enough on that one as it misses. And so it's Philadelphia holding a very comfortable 25-point lead as the quarter comes to a close. They've been playing some ferocious defense. We come back right after this. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
And I'm glad this was the pick because I love this pass. Such a great dish. That's what I call court vision.
Well, making the game easy for your teammates. All about putting them in a position to score. That's pretty.
Well, it doesn't get much better than playoff basketball. Let's get back to the action here in round one. On the court for Philadelphia to start the fourth. They've got Simmons. He's out there with Matisse Thybulle. Curry is out there with Anthony Tolliver.
When you think of Seth Curry, you're thinking shooting. But there, what a pretty pass to find the open man.
It's stolen by Curry. Great D that time from Hood. Toronto's shooting has been wayward so far. Only 37% from the floor. Flynn misses. Up top, Simmons. Goodbye, Hood. Tolliver. Boom, he jams it straight down.
Well, not exactly one of those big, burly power forwards, right? He depends on his leaping ability more than those guys, and it serves him just fine.
Bembry the pass to Baines. Here's Watanabe. A steal. Outside Flynn. Two free throws coming up, and they call the shooting foul.
Yeah, easy call.
Shooting for Toronto. Malachi Flynn at the line for two.
first free throw is good. And Philadelphia making a change here. Embiid's checked in. And he makes both free throws. First minute and a half of basketball played here in the fourth quarter. For the three, offensive rebound, and Embiid throws it down.
And guys, we've become accustomed to this. Embiid's a dynamic scorer who's comfortable shouldering the offensive load.
Flynn the pass to Baines. Flynn against Curry. Flynn misses. And so Curry will bring it up for the Philadelphia 76ers. A great fourth quarter, just giving up 2 points. He feeds it to Embiid, and the dunk by Embiid.
A one-man show offensively, and that's almost always good news for his team.
The pass to Baines, back to Flynn. Floats one up, and Embiid with the block. Now the 76ers on the break. Curry's got the ball. Tolliver with the bucket.
And it just seems that every pass they make is leading to a score. Just great ball movement.
And we're about 3 minutes into the fourth quarter. Outside Flynn pulls up on the wing. It's hauled in by Tolliver.
I think this is a spot he has got to become more consistent from. If you want to command the defender's respect.
And they double up Embiid. Curry looking it over. Five to shoot. Joe. That one, no good. And it's the Raptors taking it the other way. Outside Flynn. Here's Watanabe. And there's 2 points. Working on the glass, paying off that time.
You have to appreciate the doggedness and intensity on the glass. Wow.
Fires from deep, and Baines pulls it down. The Raptors have gone just 1-6 in the field to start the fourth quarter. A bit of a slowdown for them right now. And they're moving it up. Thibault kicks to Curry. And foul on the shot. He'll shoot two at the free throw line.
What I love is the confidence that Seth Curry plays with, and it has him attacking the defense. A little bit too physical there defensively.
Two shots.
Shooting two.
Free throw good, Curry.
Well, similar to his brother Steph, Seth is a knockdown shooter. This guy's a crafty combo guard with a number of tricks up his sleeve.
And Toronto making a change here. Johnson's checked in. He hits both from the stripe. So far, we've seen them be a bit careless with the ball.
Simply put, out of control is how they've played thus far. They're going to have to reel it in and show some more discipline.
Flynn misses.
And he has definitely been struggling in this quarter.
And you know what? They keep calling his number, and they're simply trying to get him out of this funk.
Embiid with the steal. Now Curry. Now the feed to Embiid. Hood deciding where to go with it. And again, no good by Toronto. Now the 76ers with it. They're on a 12-4 run right now. Embiid, no good. Toronto's gotten off to an 0-for-2 start from downtown here in the fourth quarter. Hood kicks to Flynn. Back to Hood. Just 5 on the clock. From deep, and again, Toronto no luck. for Philadelphia. They've gone 5 of 11 from the field in the fourth quarter. Joe, covered by Flynn. The shot by Curry, no good. Raptors shooting 34% from the field. That's not going to get it done. Hood with it, working on Tolliver, and there's the call on Joel Embiid. That is his first foul of the game. Flynn the pass to Johnson. Here's Watanabe. Pocket six. To the inside. Here's Hood. And it's Hood again missing. The 76ers shooting 48% from the field. Not bad at all. And stolen by Flynn. Here's Watanabe. And here is Flynn. Dishes it to Baines. Six on the shot clock. Pass to Watanabe. Trying to get something going. Ball's knocked loose. Out of bounds. Philadelphia takes possession. Maxey's checked in for Embiid.
Coming onto the floor for the 76ers, Tyrese Maxey.
The 76ers shooting at 42% in this final quarter. Now, here's Maxey. Outside Curry. Buries the long-range jumper. Curry's got 5 points in the quarter.
Yeah, how about the percentage they're shooting from beyond the arc here in the second half?
Back to Flynn. Takes the three. It's hauled in by Thybul.
Just can't find a shot. It's no wonder they're losing. I mean, he's been completely scoreless all night.
Chalk up two there.
Great chemistry between two teammates. Love the passing.
And here's Toronto. Guys, they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off.
Here's Baines. It's tipped. To the paint. Here's Curry. The lead pass was put in just the right spot.
How many times have we seen a possession like that from them today? Ending with a basket, coming off a pretty pass.
Pass to Johnson. Back to Flynn. To the middle. Here's Baines. No good. They had a chance to end the run there. Philadelphia's gotten just one of four three-pointers to go down for them here in the fourth. And it's Toronto with the rebound.
Boy, this guy just can't buy a bucket, and yet they have the advantage.
Flynn with it. Passes it to Watanabe. Fires for three. But they recover it. Out to Hood. Launches a three. He's off on that one. And Philadelphia the other way now.
It's almost as if there's a lid on the hoop for him right now. He still hasn't gotten one to fall in the quarter.
Here's Maxey. Can't hit that one. Maxey's gotten just four of his 10 shots to fall here, shooting 40%. Here's Hood. Can't connect from 14 feet out.
He is single-handedly dropping the temperature in here with that cold streak.
He is trying to shoot his way out of it, and it might be better for him to pass the basketball at this point.
Offensive rebound, and it's out of bounds. The 76ers able to retain possession here, and Toronto making a change here. Bembry's checked in. The 76ers also with a sub. Ben Simmons, he's checked in for Maxey. Here's Simmons. That ball is good for another field goal. His sixth. He is 6 for 9 on the stat sheet.
What a great shooting performance. His percentage is outstanding.
There's the pass to Watanabe. Pass to Bembry. Shot clock at 5. And Baines kicks to Bembry. Shot to stop the run. Johnson, the pass to Watanabe. Over Thybul. They get it again, and that one is good.
And guys, just really impressed. They made big plays when it counted, and that's why it's going to be on to the next round for the 76ers.
Fewer miscues made the difference.
I mean, a great all-around effort. Not only did they minimize their turnovers, but kept the pressure up on D, forcing the other team to commit turnovers.
And one of the key components to this victory, if not the biggest, was the incredible performance for Joel Embiid.
You can set a tone with defense, and that's exactly what he did with how he protected the rim.
There's 38 seconds left here in the fourth quarter. It's Curry with the drive, and the basket is good, and he's got a chance here for one more at the line.
That's a spirited performance. You love to get this kind of win, especially on the road.
You've got to be able to block out all distractions in enemy territory. This team did a tremendous job staying focused on the task at hand.
There's 31 seconds left in the game. Outside Flynn. Here's Watanabe. Kicks it out to Johnson. Pass to Bembry. Now here's Flynn. Here's Watanabe. And they do it. They'll move on to round two. It took them six games to do it, Greg, but they finally asserted themselves and move on to round two.
And I really think it benefits a team to have a competitive series in round one. It gets those playoff juices kind of flowing, if you will. Prevents any kind of complacency from setting in.
It's time now to go courtside as we send you over to David Aldridge from the sideline. David, take it away.
Hey, Kevin, thank you. Joel, a statement win. What should people know about this team?
You know, we're tough, especially defensively. That's our motto. We want to guard. We want to get stops. And I think we did that pretty well tonight. But, you know, we young. We're learning every day, and we're gonna be really good.
Well, looks like it's coming fast. Appreciate your time. Back to you, Kevin.
All right, David, thank you. Well, that'll do it for now. And you can join us during this first round of the Eastern Conference playoffs. For Greg Anthony, Doris Burke, and David Aldridge, and the rest of our terrific crew, this is Kevin Harlan saying thanks for watching. See you next time.